I speak English and I speak farm. That's it.
Only on them seas if it's breeze. Red ruby the sleeves. Chinese on my sleeve. These wanna be Chun-Li's. Anyway, yee-haw. Who the fuck told bitches they was me now? I knew these bitches was slow. I ain't know these bitches see now. Marry the shooter case you niggas tried to breathe.
Hi, I'm Gigi. Welcome to my channel, Gigi's Experience. Hi if you are new. Hello if you are not new. And yeah, so today I'm going to be talking about how I passed pharmacology. So I am a nursing student, RN. I'm currently taking pharm, but I'm doing so well. And I'm just like manifesting into the atmosphere and speaking the word of the tongue that I'm going to pass because I know I am. And I was like, why not make this video? Because I'm already on the right track. And you know, so last semester I was taking my general education courses. This semester I'm taking pharm, dosage, growth and development, and anatomy and physiology all at the same time. So pharm is one of the most important classes while in nursing school, because you are learning about drugs. Like, it's literally what your job is going to consist of once you start working. So it is one of the classes that you really need to take serious. But a lot of people try to make it seem like pharm is like so difficult, so hard, so complex. But I don't think so. Like, you just have to have the right study methods. So I'm going to go in and talk about 5 to 6 steps on how I passed pharm. The first 2 steps, I know people might just go over it and just be like, oh, that's not important, but it is very important. So step 1, you need to have a controlled environment. Okay, have a controlled environment. You cannot have chaos around you while you're taking this class because it's so rigorous. Like, if you can see, that's my schedule right there. We have a quiz all the time. We have exams all the time. Like, you have to constantly be studying. You take one day from studying, it's just like, so you can't have any distractions. So if you're in a relationship and it's like very time consuming or it's draining towards you, it's a toxic relationship, whatever, you need to get that sorted out. If you are in a relationship and it is healthy but you spend a lot of time with that person, you might want to like set some boundaries with that person and let them know, like, all right, I'm in this rigorous course. This is what it's going to be. I might not be able to come over as much, go out as much. And if that's your person, they're going to understand. They're going to support you. You feel me? I have my iPad right here. Got a note. So, okay. Everything just needs to be, like, controlled. You have to have an environment that you feel focused in. So, like, I know my books are over here, but I don't study in here. Like, if I study in my room, it's more like a review kind of, but not really. I study in the library. There's a library in my school. And everybody make fun of me because they're like, Gigi is a librarian because she always in the library. Like, I'm there 24/7. Like, I spend my mornings there. And after class, I go to the library because that's where I'm focused. Like, I feel like when you are surrounded by people who are working hard on their work, you're going to feed off that energy. The energy in your home is relax, like lay down, chill out. So you're gonna feed off of that energy. It's like when you go to the gym, if you're on your phone, you know at the gym you don't be on your phone. You're here to work out, like, you feel me? So where you study at and the people around you, make sure that's all in order before we even get into the studying. Or tip 2 is having the right mindset. Okay, like how I said, I'm creating this video knowing that I'm going to pass. I'm already setting the tone that I'm going to pass. I'm not even putting it in my mind that I'm not going to pass. Because what you think about is what becomes your reality. And that's just facts. What you say with your mouth is what becomes your reality. So you have to watch those 2 things. Like, you have to watch what you say and watch what you think. Because the power of the tongue is very powerful. So if you already walk into this, oh, I'm bad at math, oh, I'm a bad test taker, I ain't gonna lie, you're starting off on the wrong foot. The only reason why you are bad at math or you're a bad test taker, you had a bad teacher, you had a bad math teacher. I love math, and that's because I was blessed enough to have some really good math teachers. So it's just all about what you put into it and your attitude that you come into it with. Because all throughout high school, I was always like, I'm a bad test taker. Like, I'm going to fail this test. Like, I would always get like, I was a straight A student. But when it came to exams, like, it was like 70s, like, you know, high 70s, 80s. I didn't like my scores. And I feel like that was because like one of my teachers I was in middle school had told me, he was like, you always pushing through on anything we do. But when you get that test, it's like you just don't, you don't follow through. You don't put on what you're supposed to. So I went about life thinking, oh, I'm a bad test taker. I just went around having that mindset. But as soon as I stepped foot on campus and I was talking to my professor, I was like, yeah, I don't know. I'm feeling kind of nervous about this test because I'm a bad. I stopped right there. I said, you know what? I'm going to pass this test. And ever since then, I'm not saying that just by saying that, oh, you're going to pass the test. No, faith without works. You need to do the work too and have the faith. But as soon as I started changing my mindset, standing the tone that I'm going to be all right, I know I could walk into anything and not have fear. Like, I know God with me. I know I trust in myself. I trust in God. You know, you got to be your strongest supporter, because if you don't support yourself, nobody else going to support you more than you do. Nobody else can want this more than you do. So this is our farm book. It is a LPN book, but that's because the previous book we had, they stopped using it because it was super big and whatever. So this is an LPN book. It's more like an intro to whatever we're going to be learning. So I will, you know, this, and it comes with a study guide. This is where the nitty-gritty study tips come in. Read before you go to class, okay? Like, I haven't been doing it recently. I did do it for yesterday because we had fun. I did do it, but when I do it, it definitely makes a difference, because when you go into class without reading it before the teacher teaches to you, you have previous, without reading it, you are receiving the information, for the first time. It's all new information. It's so overwhelming, especially with the PowerPoint. It's so overwhelming. You don't know what is going on. You don't know. It's just so much information, and you feel like, how am I going to learn this? What is going on? Da, da, da. But if you read the book chapter first, before you even go into class, you already coming in with prior knowledge. You can ask a question. When the teacher is going over whatever they're going over, you already gonna be like, you're gonna have knowledge, you're gonna have a background, you're gonna have background on it. So the information is gonna be easier to receive. So definitely read the chapters before class. I saw a YouTuber was talking about how she passed farm, and she was like saying that she made flashcards and stuff. Personally, I would say no to the flashcards, because I like when I listen to my teacher and he's telling me like what to focus on. So that way I'm not making random flashcards for no reason. Like, I would make the flashcards a little bit after the lecture. So once you read the book, and you could probably do like a couple questions in here, because this is a study guide. They have like questions in here that are from the book. So probably do a little bit of questions, but make sure you familiarize yourself with the material. Then when you get in class, I always take my notes with a red pen, because red pen, I just think it does something to the brain. It makes you memorize it more, like that color like just pops out at you. So I use a red pen and I just go in and I underline anything he's saying that is important. But the main thing about farm, everything is not important. What is important is the drug class, okay? The drugs in that class, how you're administering the drug, and any adverse effects that are speaking out like, hey, focus on me. Those are important in probably drug interactions sometimes. So let me say, like, for dopamine drugs, I know, like, some people are trying to I could say when you understand the mechanism of action, how the drug, why it works like this, that your brain is naturally producing dopamine. Once you understand that, it does make it easier to understand why we're using this drug. It does make it easier, but it's not that important. That's not what the test, that's not what the NCLEX are going to test you on. That's not what your exam on that chapter is going to test you on. It's not really going to test you on that. So you need to focus on the category of the drug. What does this fall under? So like aspirin. If you see aspirin on the test, I mean, it's not just going to say just aspirin, but if you see aspirin on the test, you need to be able to associate it with the class that it goes with. Aspirin can be an anti-gout drug. Aspirin can be anything, anti-diarrheal. You don't know. Like, if you just see the drug and you only study the drug, good for you, but what is this class for? It's an NSAID. Okay, you know an NSAID. What are NSAIDs used for? It's anti-inflammatory. Everything is kind of like categories, okay? So you know that you're trying to treat anti-inflammatories, right? So you need to know the categories of anti-inflammatories. What are they? NSAIDs, DMARDs, corticosteroids. Those are the categories, right? Once you know that, you need to know each drug in the categories. Now, our teacher kind of tells us which drugs are most important, which drugs are gonna we should focus on. If your teacher puts on just drugs, like if he just talks about the question, it's just about the drug, and he's trying to ask you, what is this drug treating? But you don't know what category it belongs in, you're fucked. You're gonna be looking at that drug, and you're gonna be, cause aspirin could be for anything. Somebody might think it's for a headache, somebody with GI upset, whatever. So you need to know that, all right? Also, I use a lot of study things. Simple nursing has helped me a lot with his mnemonics. Simple nursing, and there was another one. It's another YouTube channel. They basically they associated with a picture. It's like really like a fast way to memorize like simple stuff. They put a picture and they'll be like, she has an Apple Watch, A, aspirin. It sounds stupid, but it helps, okay? But simple nursing, I definitely love simple nursing because the mnemonics he uses really sticks for me. The pictures, the graphics, I'm a visual learner, so I need to see where's this working, I need to see what it looks like. That really helped me, simple nursing. I would take notes. It helped a lot. It does. Also, flashcards is how I first went into nursing studying. I strongly advise flashcards, but you need to realize your flashcards cannot be condensed with information. That's not going to help you study. If you are condensing with a bunch of information, your brain cannot. No. And these flashcards, bro, take them with you. When you're at the car dealership, when you're doing laundry, when you're doing this, when you're doing whatever, have your flashcards. You pull them out and I drive and I'm doing my flashcards. Like, it's just quick, like, review. It's like quick review. The main thing about pharm is repetition. Like, it's how much you familiarize yourself with the material. Once you constantly are looking at this stuff, constantly reviewing it, it becomes a second language for you. Like, I speak English and I speak pharm. That's it. Hello. Also, my last study method. After you are able to, you think you got it, you think you read like the book, you think you understand. This could be for anything, for the book, for the PowerPoint, anything. Close it, get a sheet of paper, write down what you remember. Write down everything you remember. If you can't remember nothing, you ain't study right. If you can remember stuff, you got it. It's about recall. What can you recall? Because when the test there, you're not gonna have none of that book. You're not gonna have none of those things to highlight, da da da. If you can't recall it when it's a blank sheet of paper in front of you, you don't know it yet. So you need to get a paper and just write down everything. And that's it. You're going to be okay. Almost wrap. One more thing when taking a test that I do. When we have a quiz or an exam and I see something like a drug or a category, I just start listing it. Like, I start writing on the sheet of paper. I start writing on the test. So if I see a drug, I'm like, okay, this belongs in this category, and these are the adverse effects. Because once I look at the options make me just go berserk. Like, I'm just like, oh my gosh, it could be this, it could be this. But once I start writing, before I look at the question, it's like, okay, I already know my answer is definite, because that wouldn't come in my mind just because I couldn't just make that up. Okay, I think that is it. I gave y'all the gist of it. If you are in nursing school or you're thinking about doing nursing school, do it. If you're in it, do it. If you're thinking about doing it, do it. Okay? You will never know how it's going to be until you try it. Everybody's opinion is so different. Oh, don't do nursing school. Nurses get paid, boo-boo, to do all the work. Nurses do work, more work than doctors. That's slavery, da-da-da. Nurses don't get paid in Florida. Nurses don't get paid, period. Nurses are not going to be needed. Don't listen to the outside world. You need to make your decision for you. Okay, the fact that you're even thinking about it, you're watching this video like, maybe I should, you should. Just at least try it. Just do the entry exam. Like, just go for it. This is your sign from God that you need to do it. Just do it. And if you're in nursing right now, keep going. Don't give up. Don't feed into the negativity. Don't, whatever it feels like, everybody's moving quicker than you. Feels like you're at a halt in life. It'll all be worth it, and it's all gonna pay off. Like, that stuff, all that extra noise, it don't matter. It's all gonna pay off in the end. Like, you just gotta remain focused, keep your head strong, and we're gonna get this together. Okay, when I graduate, this camera's coming with me, best believe. Oh yeah. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. I hope it wasn't like too over the place, but I really wanted to give y'all just everything straightforward. Like, this is what pharm is. People make it try and seem like it's hard, it's difficult. No, it's not. Figure out your study method, stick to it. So yeah. But this was my experience taking pharmacology. It's like 10 out of 10, don't recommend.